The term continuation bet, often shortened to C-bet, describes where the last preflop raiser continues their preflop aggression by also betting the flop. When we're the preflop raiser, or 3-better or 4-better, we will often want to bet the flop. But why is this the case? Well, because one, our opponent will always have some folds in each spot, and picking up pots uncontested is a significant source of profit. Two, as the preflop raiser, many of our hands will be fairly strong, so we want to increase the size of the pot. And three, the hands in our range which aren't especially strong are protected by the stronger ones. These weaker hands get to win the pot more often by bluffing or by making the best hand if our opponent's aggression is restricted after we bet, given that we still have strong hands. The preflop raiser will quite often maintain the betting lead and pressure throughout the hand. They're more likely to end up with the nuts on the river because they're more likely to have the nuts on the flop. This is because their preflop range contains all the strongest hands, while the preflop caller's range will not. As a result, the level of aggression the preflop raiser can flex is going to be very high. But sometimes the preflop raiser's ability to continue aggression is limited, like on board textures where the caller's range is especially strong. On a flop of 9-8-7 with a flush draw, either player can potentially possess two pair hands, straights, and flush draws. As a result, the preflop raiser has to temper their overall level of aggression to protect themselves against all these strong hands. If you've ever blasted off with pocket aces on this board and ran into a flopped straight, you've learned this lesson firsthand. Some flops make it harder for the preflop raiser to possess the nuts at all. For example, a low connected flop in a 3-bet pot. The 3-better likely doesn't possess many hands which make sets or straights on this board, but the caller does. As a result, the 3-better has to be extremely cautious with the hands they choose to bet. We call this phenomenon nut advantage. Let's use it in a sentence. Whichever player is more likely to have the best possible hand in a given spot has the nut advantage. If the flop comes down and you have nut advantage, then you have the opportunity to be aggressive. Your decisions, however, do not stop there. In the next lesson, we will discuss sizing.